Hello everyone, I am your fitness coach and a nutritionist Sonia Bajaj. Today I am going to tell you about the 5 most important exercises for the beginners to lose your belly fat or to tone up your abdominal area. Just 5 exercises for upper, middle and lower abdomens. So we start by taking a mat and lying down on a mat. The first exercise I would like to tell you about is the upper abdomen. The two muscles which you see here is a very common abdomen exercise which we call as crunches. But people make a lot of mistakes in doing the crunches where they use a lot of neck than using the shoulders. They do not keep their abdomen squeezed while doing a crunch. So the two most important things which are to be kept in mind is that when you crunch, the movement is from the shoulders and not your neck. Secondly, whenever you are crunching, you have to breathe out when your shoulders go up away from the floor. And then the next one is keep your core engaged. Keep your abdomen tight whenever even you are doing a crunch position. Or even when you are sitting like this, the way I am sitting right now, see that you always sit in a position with your abdomen always tight. Just don't leave your belly loose. Just this is a function of your abdomen. So just keep it contracted, keep your core tight. So automatically you will see awesome results. So we start with the first exercise for the upper ab, which we call as a crunch. This exercise we are going to do for the upper ab, which is crunch. So lie down on your back, open your legs shoulder width apart, toes facing straight, lie down, take your arms under your neck to support your neck, looking up towards the ceiling, elbows facing straight up towards the ceiling. And now see that there's always a little gap between your chin and your neck when you crunch. So we start, first of all, keeping the posture correct, keeping your abdomen, lower abdomen tight and contracted. We lift up our neck, so you lift up your shoulders, going up straight, breathing out. Coming back down, inhaling again. Breathing out. Coming back again, inhaling. So my elbows do not bend right, left, up or down. They're absolutely straight. My arm parallel to the ceiling and my chin looking up and I crunch, giving a lot of impact on my upper abdomen. My lower abdomen is tightly engaged, it's tightly squeezed in. So breathing out, we go up again. The movement is from the shoulders. The shoulders lift away from the mat and we go up, breathing out. Hold it for a fraction of a second. Coming back, inhaling to the floor again. Breathing out, we go up, inhale and we come down. Breathing out, inhale and we come down again. So this was a crunch, the very basic exercise for a beginner. If you are a beginner, so we can do 3 sets of 12 repetitions each, and slowly and slowly as we improve, we can do a lot of variations in a crunch itself. So at least start with this, start with the upper crunch and see the results you get. So the second exercise we are going to do is for the middle section, the middle abdomens, and let's go for it. Take your hands, as we are a beginner, take your hands, support your lower back, keeping your hands under your lower back. Now slowly lift your butt away from the floor and come down, touching the floor. Breathing out, let's go up again. Coming down, let's touch the floor. And you're back. As you are a beginner, don't expect too much of going up away from the floor. Go at your own pace. See that the lower back is not hampered. Please take a consultation from your doctors before doing any kind of abdominal exercises, as it's a lot of cooperation from the lower back which is required when you are doing abdominal exercises. So once more, the middle section we are going to do is keeping your hands under the lower back for a beginner. Breathing out, going up, inhaling and coming back. Breathe out, come back, and come back.
Again, we can, as a beginner, we can start with 3 sets of 12 repetitions, and as we keep on increasing our days of workout, we can increase the sets or we can increase the repetition and see the results coming out. Now let us go to the most stubborn fat, which is the lower abdomen, the pelvic, the lower pelvic region, and a few exercises to tone up your lower abdomen. Just lying down straight on your back again. Most important and stubborn area is the lower abdomen.
so where the maximum fat and the chitin is accumulated. The exercise for this requires your lower back to be properly strengthened, and if you have a low back pain, please consult your doctor before doing the exercise which I'm going to right now tell you. So keeping your hands straight, put them under your lower back again. Slowly lift your legs up, slightly bending your knees. Inhaling, come down. Slowly lift your legs up. Your knees are slightly bent and come down. Breathing out, let's go up. Inhale and we come down. And we come down. And we come down. Again, remember that your core is tight. When you are lifting your legs up and or you are bringing your legs down, your core is totally engaged. You are keeping it tight. Another good variation to this for the people who are beginners or people who have a low back pain is to keep your lower backs and under your hands under your lower back. And you can also go by just starting lifting your one leg up at a time and bringing it back down again. And bringing it down back again. Slowly, when you increase the strength of your abdomen and your lower back, can we go for both legs up, both legs down. Inhale and come back. And come back. So again, remember, this requires a lot of strength from the lower back. Again and again, my remembrance to you is, because I have seen a lot of people just getting a lot of low back pain because of the leg raises and regrets later on. So you can even go single leg up, right and then left, right and then left. Slowly, when you see that you are able to cope up, you can lift both legs up, which is no doubt much more impactful on your lower abs. So again, 3 sets of 10 to 12 repetitions as you feel comfortable being a beginner. Let's start with this exercise and see that it is not only helpful for your abs but also for your legs. Now, when we are talking about our abdomen region, we cannot forget obliques. Obliques are the most important part of our entire abdomen region. So to strengthen the obliques so that we can strengthen our entire abdomen is very important. So obliques workout is here for you again to try it out. 3 sets of 10 to 12 repetitions. Lying down again on your back straight, keeping your arms behind you. Breathing out, lift your right leg and left arm up. With your leg going up, try taking your arm as close to the toe as possible. Inhaling and going back. Now again, left leg and right arm going up with your neck coming up, breathing out. Again, see that the movement is from the shoulders when you get up. It's not the neck movement, it's a shoulder movement away from the floor. Neck is again looking up. The chin does not attach your neck. There's always a little gap between your chin and your neck. So again, going back. Now, once you're comfortable with this and you find this pretty okay to go with, and now you're moving ahead, we can always go both legs up together, both arms coming up, with your shoulders coming up, breathing out. Hold it for a fraction of a second, inhale and we go back. This is very impactful for your entire abdomen region. Start with the single leg raise and alternate toe touch, and then slowly advance to the both legs coming up together with. Again, here also your lower back has to be properly intact doing this exercise. If any lower back problem, please consult your doctor or go with a single leg raise up. Hold it for a fraction of a second. Slightly your knees are bent. Lower abdomen is totally engaged. And inhale and we go back. Last time again. The movement is on the shoulder. There's a gap between your chin and your neck. Your arms are going as close to the toes as possible. Inhale and we go back. For the beginners, I would always advise to start with a single alternate arm and leg, and slowly when you advance and your lower back is ready to accept it, please go ahead with both arms coming up, with both legs going up together to see more impact on your abdominal region. Again, 3 sets of 10 to 12 repetitions is very good enough for the beginners. Last but not the least, my favorite exercise for abdomen is a plank. People who have done plank and they could see the amount of pressure they could feel in their lower abs, the amount of strength they realize they have in their shoulders and also in their lower back and butt. So a compound exercise which no doubt needs a lot of time to start with and reach to a level where you can hold a plank for around a minute. So for the beginners, I would always advise to start with a plank for holding it for 5 seconds to 10 seconds, going on to 15 seconds to 20 seconds. See again that you do under proper guidance to start with and to learn the technique and to learn the correct posture. Because if you are not in a correct posture in the plank, you can always go off with your lower back. So sitting in this position only, putting your elbows on the floor, your palm facing down. If you are a beginner, you can always keep your palm also like this. Now, taking your knees 1 and 2 above the floor and see that your back is like a tabletop where even if I keep a cup of tea, it does not fall down. It is not bending like this. It's not stooping in a camel position. It's absolutely straight. And if you want, you can keep your palms on the floor or you can hold your palm up like this and see that you don't throw your neck too low and you don't look up. It's looking squarely down and holding it for as long as you can. See that again, your abdomens you make a conscious effort to keep your lower abdomens tight to your lower back. Your abdomen to your spine. Hold it for as, see my lower back is not stooping down, that's going to kill the lower back. It's not up like a camel position. But if really it's uncomfortable, slight camel would still go better than your stooping down. Hold it for as long as you can. Slowly relax back and down. To start with, hold it for 5 seconds. Slowly and slowly, in days, go on to 10 seconds. Don't expect too much of perfection, but do it under proper guidance. All the exercises of abdomen, they require a lot of strength from your lower back also. So once you are done with the abdominal exercises, don't forget to stretch your lower back, which is very, very important and about which people are not aware or they do not bother. Please, whenever you are doing your abdominal exercises, to stretch your back is very, very important. So a little back strengthening exercises and stretches after your abdominal workouts is very, very important. So these were the 5 exercises which I showed you right now to fight with your stubborn belly fat. But the points I would like you to remember is that please do the exercises under proper guidance of your fitness coach. And even if you're watching this, just see that you do keep in mind all the points which I have mentioned again and again of the breathing pattern, of the posture and about the lower back and any pains in the lower back. Or if you are recommended by the doctor to take care of your lower back or you have a spine problem or slip disc problem, see that you take a green signal from your doctor to do all this. So now if you have any queries regarding your abdominal exercises or your nutrition on abdomen, you can connect me on my Facebook page, which is Stay Strong, or you can mail me on my email address here.